at the end, it should go like something like this.
We are wrapping up our Virginia Colony unit in social studies. So we wanted to provide some activities that would connect to what we've been learning about for the last few weeks and help the kids have a better understanding of what life would be like for people living in Virginia in the 1600s and 1700s. Some of these activities have been traditions, like we've done them every year with the fourth graders as we try to expose the students to just a little bit about what life would have been like.
I'm leading a Nine Men's Morris. It's like a colonial game that's like sort of a mix between tic-tac-toe and checkers.
So the goal of this game is to make a row of three.
So we were trying to help the students look at primary sources and figure out how the first Americans in Virginia would have made their houses. So they're using pipe cleaners and paper, but then trying to construct a Yahaken as it would have been constructed hundreds of years ago. We also did churning butter, but it took a long time to make this little bit of butter for their bread. So we want them to better understand that there's a lot that goes into making food and making products. Another activity that we did was tin punching, so that the students would understand, you know, if they're decorating a lantern or decorating something, it would take labor.
So basically we would take a piece of paper and we would take a little pin and then we poke all the holes that is in the picture that we're trying to make. She really liked it because the sound of it and the ending result of the printing.
And we did weaving as well, and we were trying to help the students understand that weaving is done throughout the world, and so the people coming into Virginia would have had different traditions of weaving, and people adapt their cultures as they move to a new place. Really, the point of social studies is to know that it's a story of people and that people did these things and people experienced these events. So hopefully by, you know, doing some hands-on activities or studying primary sources or investigating an artifact, our students will start to understand that real people did real things.